Imagine experiencing trembling hands, uncontrollable muscle spasms, severe mood swings, paranoia, memory loss, confusion, hallucinations, and severe depression. Picture a life where your body betrays you, where you are trapped in a fog of fear and delirium. These were the horrifying realities for many individuals, but the cause of their torment remained a mystery for centuries. Today, we uncover the chilling story of Mad Hatter disease. Let's journey back to the 17th and 18th centuries, a time when the hat-making industry was flourishing. The stylish hats of the era, crafted from fine animal furs, were in high demand. The process of making these hats was intricate and labor-intensive, involving various stages of preparation, treatment, and shaping. But behind the scenes of this fashionable industry, a dark secret lurked. Meet Thomas, a skilled artisan in Danbury. Known for his meticulous craftsmanship and steady hand, Thomas was a pillar of his community, admired for his dedication and skill. He had a wife, Sarah, and two young children, Emily and Jack. Their home was filled with love and laughter, a stark contrast to the dark reality that awaited Thomas at work. Over time, Thomas began to notice a slight tremor in his hands. Initially, he dismissed it as fatigue, but the tremor grew worse. Soon he could barely hold his tools. His mood darkened, and he became irritable, lashing out at his family and colleagues. Sarah watched helplessly as the man she loved transformed into a shadow of his former self. The once vibrant and joyful home became a place of tension and fear. Emily and Jack, confused and frightened, kept their distance from their father. In the dimly lit workshop, the air thick with the smell of chemicals, Thomas's shaking hands struggled to complete the delicate tasks. The walls, lined with tools and unfinished hats, seemed to close in on him. The other hatters whispered among themselves, their own fears mirrored in Thomas's plight. The clatter of tools and the rustling of fabric were punctuated by Thomas's frustrated groans and occasional outbursts. The once harmonious environment had turned into a nightmare. Thomas started experiencing vivid hallucinations, seeing shadows that weren't there and hearing whispers in the night. Paranoia gripped him and he became convinced that he was being watched. His family, unable to understand his erratic behavior, grew fearful. Sarah would wake up in the middle of the night to find Thomas pacing the house, muttering to himself. Eventually, Thomas had to be restrained for his own safety. His once steady hands shook uncontrollably, and he could no longer work or care for himself. He was institutionalized, spending his remaining days in a state of constant agitation and confusion. As the 19th century progressed, more and more cases like Thomas's were reported. Physicians and scientists began to investigate, trying to uncover the cause of this mysterious illness. The key to the puzzle lay in the very process that made the hats so desirable. The felting process, used to create the smooth, durable felt, involved treating animal furs with a substance known as mercuric nitrate. This chemical was essential for turning the coarse fur into fine felt, but it had a hidden, deadly side effect. Hatters were exposed to mercury vapors as they worked with the treated furs, inhaling the toxic substance day after day. The mercury accumulated in their bodies, leading to a condition known as mercury poisoning. The symptoms of mercury poisoning matched those experienced by the hatters' tremors, mood swings, memory loss, hallucinations, paranoia, and severe depression. The realization was both groundbreaking and horrifying. The very substance that allowed hatters to craft their beautiful creations was slowly poisoning them. The term Mad Hatter disease became synonymous with mercury poisoning, forever linking the two in the annals of medical history. Isaac Newton, the renowned physicist and mathematician, is believed to have suffered from mercury poisoning due to his alchemical experiments. In his later years, Newton exhibited symptoms such as tremors, memory loss, and erratic behavior. Analysis of his hair revealed high levels of mercury, suggesting chronic exposure. Newton's genius was shadowed by the torment of mercury's effects, illustrating how even the brightest minds were not immune to its dangers. Another notable figure was Vincent van Gogh, the brilliant but troubled artist. Van Gogh's erratic behavior, hallucinations, and mental health issues have been linked by some experts to mercury or lead poisoning, possibly from the paints he used. While this remains speculative, it adds a haunting layer to the tragic story of his life and work. Van Gogh's vibrant and emotive paintings stand in stark contrast to the darkness that consumed his mind. Mary Todd Lincoln, the wife of President Abraham Lincoln, reportedly took a medication called Blue Mass that contained mercury. She exhibited symptoms such as mood swings, depression, and erratic behavior, which could have been exacerbated by mercury poisoning. Her struggles highlight the widespread and insidious nature of mercury's effects, even outside of industrial settings. Mary Todd Lincoln's life was marked by tragedy and turmoil, and the added burden of mercury poisoning only compounded her suffering. And then there's Lewis Carroll, the author of Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. While Carroll was not officially diagnosed with mercury poisoning, his creation of the Mad Hatter character reflects an awareness of the condition. The term mad as a hatter was already in common use, inspired by the bizarre and erratic behavior observed in hatmakers. Carroll's whimsical and surreal world of Wonderland took on a darker edge with the inclusion of the Mad Hatter, a character who embodied the madness associated with mercury poisoning. Let's now delve into some other lesser-known but equally gruesome historical cases of mercury poisoning to truly grasp the extent of its impact. In a German hatmaking factory during the early 20th century, a female worker, exposed to high levels of mercury vapor, developed extreme symptoms. She experienced severe tremors, uncontrollable muscle spasms, and intense mood swings. Her condition worsened rapidly, leading to episodes of extreme paranoia and violent outbursts. The worker's mental state became so unstable that she was deemed a danger to herself and others. She was committed to an asylum where she spent the remainder of her life in a state of constant agitation and confusion. This case drew significant attention and contributed to early occupational health reforms in Germany. Another tragic case involved a hatter named Matthias Bouin, who worked in London during the 19th century. Bouin's case was particularly gruesome due to the progression of his symptoms. He suffered from violent tremors, debilitating muscle weakness, and intense psychological symptoms, including severe depression and hallucinations. His condition deteriorated to the point where he was unable to work or care for himself. Bouin's prolonged exposure to mercury led to a slow and painful decline, ultimately resulting in his premature death. His case was documented in medical journals of the time, highlighting the dire consequences of unregulated mercury use in industry. Mercury poisoning was not limited to the hat-making industry. In the mid-20th century, one of the most severe cases of mercury poisoning occurred in Minamata, Japan. Known as Minamata Disease, this tragedy was caused by the industrial discharge of methyl mercury into Minamata Bay. The contaminated seafood was consumed by the local population, leading to widespread mercury poisoning. Victims suffered from severe neurological damage, including loss of motor control, sensory disturbances, and profound psychological effects. Some exhibited grotesque deformities and intense suffering. The realization of mercury's role in causing these diseases marked a turning point in occupational health and safety. In the early 20th century, regulatory changes began to take shape. The use of mercuric nitrate in hat making was gradually phased out, and alternative non-toxic chemicals were introduced. Improved ventilation and safety measures were implemented in workshops, reducing the exposure to harmful vapors. Public health campaigns and occupational safety standards emerged, aimed at protecting workers from toxic substances. The tragic stories of those who suffered from Mad Hatter disease played a crucial role in driving these changes. Their suffering was not in vain. It led to greater awareness and a commitment to preventing such horrors in the future. As we reflect on the dark history of Mad Hatter disease, we are reminded of the importance of safeguarding workers' health and safety. The story of the Hatters serves as a haunting testament to the dangers of industrial chemicals and the necessity of regulation and vigilance. Thank you for joining me on this journey into the shadows of the past. I hope you found this exploration of Mad Hatter disease as chilling and enlightening as I did. Please remember to like and subscribe to our channel. History has many dark corners, and we will continue to uncover them here on Haunted Harmony. Until next time, stay curious and stay safe.